ask members of the public to leave the room, but the issue will be back fairly quickly, my hopes. And Mr. Brace, you're welcome to leave your tripod as long as you take the camera.
Chair, can I just clarify the process of those parts? Yes. With regards to item three, it's fine for you to consider matters appearing in the report set out. Once you have dealt with that aspect of the report, I would then invite you to move to the exemption and determine whether you should do the exemption in order that the matter appearing in the exempt part of the agenda can be then dealt with and that will dispense with item three.
Will we then deal with all other items of the exemption?
Yeah, you can then come, as part of your exempt session, you can then also consider and decide what is put back into the public domain or open session.
Intended that we seek somebody who's currently, ideally, a serving director, someone with experience in the social care element of children's services. And we've also done some market testing with the likely salary that we need in order to recruit the type of candidate we need to be able to take the role forward in children's services. And that before you is a figure between a band of £140,000 to £155,000 per annum. That's the first post. The second post is Director of Finance. The current person who's acting as 151 officer is retiring. He will stay with us on a reduced hours capacity until the new post holder is appointed. We want to look at a candidate who will have had experience of managing large budgets, but also somebody who will be able to advise us on our work around income generation, which will be a larger feature of financial management across all local governments, but particularly in this council, we already have a plan for that. I would like to be able to look for somebody to fill this post, not just in the local government world, but also a broader search for people, perhaps with a commercial or other type of sector experience. And the third role is Assistant Director for Law and Governance and Monitoring Officer. We will be losing our current post holder. Is trying to be conspicuous in this room as I'm speaking, to move to a job much, much closer to where he currently lives. And we would seek to replace like for like in terms of no changes to the job. But we will obviously need somebody who will be able to lead for the council on issues both of law and of governance. And it's important to emphasise the two aspects. So they're the three posts that we bring to you to recommend. significant progress in the last 6 to 9 months around integration with the NHS. It is going incredibly well. This post will increasingly be shared across health and social care. And Cabinet has already agreed to the integration of all the people's services from the community trust and also in principle to move to a joint arrangement of an integrated care hub across social care commission, public health commission and NHS commission. It feels appropriate that all that work to receive the necessary focus over the next 12 months that post now reports to me. So we can give significant, or I can bring my expertise because as the panel will know that I've been involved in this in the past and I would really like to be able to support Ray very closely on making sure this is the right deal for the council and for the people involved. The next role is the Assistant Director for Commissioning Support. We've had someone in post since February. She extensively interacts with colleagues in the strategic program and commissioning, and I feel it makes much more sense for her to be based within the strategic program and the business services in order to move that agenda forward. The third change is around the Director of Transformation, who has reviewed his current role, and we've discussed what levers he needs to enable him to make sure the transformation is managed most effectively. And we propose two changes to that. One is that the Director of Finance reports to this post holder rather than the Director of Business Services. And secondly, that the Assistant Director for Human Resources and Organisation Development reports to this post holder too. We also propose that the pensions function sits with the Director of Finance, which is usual in most authorities, and that this post of Transformation Director have a change in title to that of Corporate Resources and Reform. And finally, to talk about business services. We have a long-standing member of staff, highly valued, who is currently in this role. He has expressed a wish, as he's 64 years of age, to move to a reduced hours arrangement of 4 days a week. I propose we grant that wish because it's about journey to retirement. He has said that he will not wish to activate that until all of his posts are filled. And I propose to the committee that we approve that decision. Two final points. One is that this is a very, very difficult market to recruit to a number of these jobs, and we need help and advice on that. So I recommend that Pecuniary will help us on those senior appointments be appointed to assist. And finally, in terms of finances, although it's not clear on what paper we'll appoint the individuals concerned to the posts,
to necessarily read some of the journals that we usually advertise in. So with a couple of observations and hopefully a couple of answers to those questions.
So, you know, we should always obviously be very prudent with the funding, because it's council taxpayers' money, but if we do, you know, this is the most important point we will be making in the next few years, and it's absolutely critical that we get it right. And, you know, whether you like it or not, Lesley, salary is a big element of the package that we need to put together to get the best in the business. And we are, as Eric said, targeting sitting existing directors. So, you know, all the evidence that we've got from people who know the market and know that the people in the market at the moment is to recruit the best. This is where we're going to fetch it. And, you know, I recognise it's a big increase from the existing salary level, but I just think it's something that we've got to do, really. So, I think there is a strong argument for saying we do need to pitch it at that.
Everyone's Phil.
Try to choose my words carefully because I try to be diplomatic. But I went back through some of the reports we had in 2012 and I wasn't on this committee then. So I went back to look at the creation of strategic directors and the way that worked out in practice. I also looked back at the report we had last October, which had a list of posts deleted, posts created, posts regraded, and claimed to be a saving of £348,000 after all that. I also went back to the job descriptions of some of the strategic directors and therefore began to ask what had the creation of those particular posts actually achieved in practice. And that's where I've got problems with language. However, we seem to be having this, as Lesley correctly spend a few minutes with Mr. Williams and Mr. Armstrong, but I said I'd think about it, but I remained unconvinced by some of the shuffling and changes that I see on the charts, I'm afraid. Often thought that finance had a lowly position in the authority, and I think back to that, and we've been very lucky to have somebody who's been with us for longer than I've been on the council, frankly, who's worked right up from being looking after housing management and budgets and things, and worked right to the top. But I'm not sure that finance has had the drive that it needed. Terms of transformation, it's not that long since we recruited that officer, so I don't understand why that post has to change. And I still, despite what's been said about the health service, I'm not sure it's yet ready to move that officer across to do more on that, because I still see social and care and other services having particular problems. I think if we've got people in post to do particular things, why are we moving off to do other things? And we live in a world where we keep bringing in lots of interims to do things. And I recognise an interim is going to be necessary for the period that the tour isn't going to be helping us anymore. So I have a very sceptical approach to the whole paper. But I recognise the need to go out and recruit people for finance and children's services. The others I still need some convincing of.
Discussion so far, okay.